Hi there, my name is Irene, and in this video, we are going to talk about worksets within Revit collaboration. So let's get to it. All right, so most people discover the existence of worksets the hard way, the bad way, when they try to make a change in a project, and then they get a little warning that tells them, no, you cannot. This geometry does not belong to you. It belongs to somebody else, and therefore you cannot change it. You have to ask that person's permission, right? So that is because of worksets. So the first thing that we need to understand about worksets is why do they exist? And there's actually a really good reason because, again, remember, when we are working with collaboration, it's important to understand that, again, it's not just the interior design team that is made out of two or three people. You are going to have a bunch of multidisciplinary consultants coming in to bring different skill sets, different things that they are going to be modeling. So I'm going to simplify this. Worksets were designed because engineers got tired of the architects and interior designers and the plumbers and everybody else moving their columns and beams, right? Because let's face it, like every single time that I'm working in a new project, the first question is, I don't like that column there. Can we move it? So I'm pretty sure that worksets was just like the guild of engineers saying, for the love of Christ, let us protect our columns, right? So that is basically the purpose of worksets. It's the idea that you are going to have different teams with different tasks or different parts of the project to develop. And basically then those teams can take ownership and say like, well, I modeled this and nobody else can mess up with it. If you want to mess up with it, you have to ask my permission because then I can say yes or no. So how do worksets work? Very simple. In your Collaborate tab, you are going to go here where it says worksets. This is a file that has already been shared. It is already been collaborated on. And basically what you're going to see is that by default, Revit starts with worksets. There is a workset for shared views, levels, and grids. So these are basically datum elements. And then you have workset one, which is basically for geometry. And the way that this works is that I can come here and let's say I'm going to create a new workset that is going to be regular Irene, right? And I want this workset, like the elements from this workset, to be visible in all views. So I'm going to say okay. And you can see that here it is going to show things that are user created. So I can come here and say okay. Do you want to make regular Irene workset the active workset? Yes. So what's going to happen now is that you can see that my active workset is regular Irene. And what's going to happen now is that if I come here, I'm going to make a wall, right? So I'm going to make this wall here. There we go. And now I'm going to do my synchronizing so Evil Irene can have access to the model, right? So I'm going to say, okay, synchronize. And we're going to go here, okay. And it is going to update. So now, jumping to Evil Irene's computer, you can see that the new wall has been added. And this is what's going to happen. If I select this wall here and I go MV to move it, let's say I just want to move it down, you're going to get an error message that is telling me that this element cannot be changed because regular Irene made it. So she has to relinquish and then you have to reload latest. So basically what's happening here is, remember, if we go to collaborate and we go to worksets, now there is a new workset and the geometry that was made with that workset is basically going to be blocked. I cannot work with it. In fact, I'm trying, maybe on the 3D view, I can see it. If I come here, so basically what's going to happen sometimes with these kind of files is that you will open them and you will see a symbol, like I'm going to put it on the screen, but it's basically like three cubes with like a cross. So basically that is an immediate indication that this is something that somebody else did and you cannot change. So very, very important to understand that, like, when you work with worksets, you're basically taking ownership of geometry and you're also blocking other people from being able to work with it. So again, let's say that like I see that regular Irene created a workset and I'm like, oh really? Two people can play the same game and I can come here and say, okay, well now we have Evil Irene's workset as well. Why not? So what's going to happen now is that this is going to be my active workset, right? So what you can see is that in Evil Irene's computer, Evil Irene is the active workset. In regular Irene's computer, regular Irene workset is the active workset. So I can come here and say, okay, I'm going to make a wall that is going to be an Evil Irene wall. In fact, if I select it and you go down on the properties, you're going to see under identity data that this workset belongs to Evil Irene. It was created, it's the Evil Irene and it was edited by my account. So if I go here and I synchronize again, okay, and now we jump to regular Irene and we update, we're going to see that if I try to move this guy, I'm going to have the same issue. So this is important to understand. It's not like, oh, one of you is like went first and that's why this is happening to you. No, this is because like each of you has your own work sets and basically you are forbidding each other from working with other people. And again, what I want to clarify here is that this is not inherently a bad thing. This was created on purpose to protect your model from other people messing up with it. But the problem is that if you're working in a small team or you're working internally, like let's say you're all part of the same team, part of the same department, then this might actually become a hurdle because it's like, oh, like, you know, we have to be asking permission constantly and jumping back and forth and whatnot. So the ideal solution here is that you do not want to work with Worksets if you are a small team. You may want to come here to Worksets and delete them. Now, keep in mind that if I select Evil Irene, I cannot delete other people's Worksets. I can only delete my Workset. So see, if I select my Workset, I can come here and say, let's delete this guy, right? And I want to move it to just like the default Workset 1, right? And I can come here and say, okay. So what you're going to see now is that these, if you remember, I created this one as part of like the, like my Workset, regular Irene. You're going to see that now this guy is part of Workset 1. But if I come here and I synchronize and I jump back to Evil Irene's computer and I update, you're going to see that now this guy, see how it says Workset? And I can come here, MV, and I can move it. So this is option 1, and then that's it. You have just like deleted the Workset. Now, the other thing that you can do is you can just basically say nobody works with Worksets. This is a Workset free project. So how can you do that? Because again, if I come here, there's still the Evil Irene Workset, right? And I cannot delete that one because I didn't create it. So the other thing that we can do is we can actually go back to the homepage, back to Autodesk Docs. I can come here, and what you're going to see is that I can come here and say that I want to relinquish. So you can do it two different ways. If I come back here, you can click here to relinquish all mine, but this is only going to allow you to relinquish your worksets. This is not going to have other people relinquishing their worksets. Like I would have to go to Evil Irene and on Evil Irene's computer, say relinquish all mine. So see, Revit cannot relinquish the change elements because the project has not been saved. You must first synchronize the changes. So, okay, fine. Let's synchronize here. We're going to go okay. And we're going to talk about this when, well, actually, let's talk about it. So one easy way that you can do it is when you go to synchronize, now we can talk about this guy here. See, after synchronizing, relinquish the following worksets and elements. So I can relinquish things that I borrowed, or I can relinquish my user created worksets. So if I do this, this is kind of automatic. And what will happen, there you go. So now if we go back to regular Irene, if you remember, it was this guy here on the right that was, see, so this change, obviously, but then I should also be able to move this guy here, see, because Evil Irene relinquished. So if you want to work with worksets for whatever reason, but then you also want other people to be able to work with your geometry, then you need to make sure that you relinquish. So you can either relinquish when you are synchronizing, or you can relinquish by after you synchronize, relinquishing all mine. But if you want to work in a project that is free from Worksets, then what you're going to do is you're going to go back to the homepage and you're going to come here and you're going to click relinquish. And what this is going to do is show you the current worksets that are operating. And you can basically say force a relinquish. So this is basically just going to kick out everyone. So if I click here, then it's not going to really matter who did what, who said what. Okay? Everyone is going to get kicked out. And you will know that you have done things correctly if you go to relinquish and see that currently none of the team members owns any elements in the model. That's good. That means that everyone can work with everything. So if you say this is the first one that I did, same thing. I have to come here, relinquish. And again, I have to say like, no, I don't want to work with like any worksets. Okay. So again, ideally, you don't do any worksets and then you don't have to deal with this. But if for whatever reason, like your project requires you to work with worksets, but was, oh yeah. So this is just basically telling me that like my ownership was relinquished. So I cannot do work sharing, right? I can only work with Evil Irene if I want to, or I can work with Workset 1, right? Remember, I got rid of my work share. So see, I can come here and say, okay, fine. I'm going to relax. We're just all going to continue working with the Workset. So again, you all want to work with Workset 1 unless you want to say like, I'm going to do this and you're going to do this and you're not going to be able to touch my stuff and I'm not going to be able to touch your stuff. Otherwise, you can synchronize. Again, see how it doesn't give me the option to relinquish anything because I am not like taking ownership of anything. We're just all working with Workset 1. And if I come back here, again, you're going to see that if I go here to relinquish, it's still telling me that currently none of the team members own any elements in the model because I relinquish, right? Like if we go here to this guy, you can see it's Workset 1. Now, this is just on my end, but it is important to understand that like I relinquished on my end. I basically forced that like I'm not going to work with like work sharing, like I'm only going to be working, but evil Irene still exists. In fact, if I come here and I select this guy, you can see that it is still associated with evil Irene. Now, because I relinquish, you're going to see that basically your file is going to get stuck in a loop. So very, very important. If you did the relinquishing that we just went through, just to kind of like reset things, what you can do is you can close the file. You can choose to synchronize or not synchronize. Usually it's going to be easier if you just do not save or save locally. And then again, you can copy paste. Because again, what's going to happen is that depending on how you've set up your project, it may get stuck in this, in this kind of loop where it says like the operation cannot be completed because you did a change to something that didn't belong to you and you cannot do that. See? So it's telling me like, no, you tried doing something to something that wasn't yours and you're not supposed to. So what, again, if you have made any changes that you actually wanted to keep, then you're going to go and say that you want to save that locally. In this case, I'm just going to close this file here. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to reopen. Again, if we come here, you're going to see that there's no current ownership of anything in the model. I'll keep my changes and open the model so that I can view it as a new model or discard my changes and open the latest version. So again, this will happen if you made changes after. Basically, when you relinquish, you need to just close the file. If you just go and continue working, like it's again, it's creating a branching and you don't want to do that. Because what you're going to see here, if we go to collaborate, is that the evil Irene file still exists. And in fact, here you can see that it is the default work set because that's what evil Irene had. If I select this wall here, it is still evil Irene. But as you can see, it doesn't say who it has been edited by because it was relinquished. So if I go here, MV, you're going to see that it will let me move it. But let's see what's going to happen when I synchronize. All right. If I go here to my homepage, as you can see, still nothing to relinquish. If I go to Evil Irene's computer and I update, it's going to jump. Now, what I could do here is I could take this guy and say that I no longer want it to be Evil Irene. Instead, I want it to be Workset 1 and get rid of that. So again, if you're having that issue and it's bothering you, you can just take all of your geometry and say, I just want all of it to be like Workset 1, right? Like I don't want any specific worksets. So if you want to make sure that everyone can work and you are not getting any issues with worksets, just make sure that your active workset is always Workset 1. And then when you go on the Autodesk docs, make sure that your project gives you this message when you go into relinquishing. With that, we have reached the end of this video. I hope you find that helpful. If you have any questions, by all means, feel free to add them in the comment. Also, you know, feel free to give it a like, give it a follow, subscribe, all the engagement things. Otherwise, thank you very much for joining us. Thank you very much for sticking through, and I will see you in the next one. Have a good one. Bye.